আসসালামু আলাইকুম স্টুডেন্ট অফ ক্লাস ফোর, ইউর টুডেস টপিক ইজ জিওমেট্রি এমসিকিউ টাইপ কোশ্চেন অ্যান্ড শর্ট কোশ্চেন। লাস্ট উইক উই হ্যাভ অলরেডি লার্নড ডিফারেন্ট ফিচার্স অফ ডায়াগ্রাম, জিওমেট্রিক ডায়াগ্রাম, and also we have learned how to draw different angles. Today we will learn various MCQ type question and short questions. I again inform everybody that this class is for the student of class 4 subject mathematics and especially for English version, student of English version. Now we will try to learn some short questions at first, then we will try to learn some MCQ type question. All the students are requested to be attentive. Now please look at the screen. You will find some short question. Here the first question is given. What is called the dot made by the 4.4 front of a pencil on the paper? And you know that the answer will be point. Then what do we get by putting a scale on the paper and joining two points? The answer will be a straight line. It will be more than one point. Then what do we get by putting a scale on the paper and joining two points named A and B? We have already learned this in the first geometry class, that is called a line segment. You know that a line segment has two end points. Remember that a line segment has two end points, but both the sides of a straight line is endless. Now next question. What does a line segment have? A line segment has a definite length. Next question. What does a line segment have? You can also write that a line segment has two endpoints. It is also right. What does we get if the line segment is extended in both directions endlessly? You know that a straight line, both the sides of a straight line is endless. So if the line segment is extended in both directions endlessly, so it will be a model of a straight line. Then what does a line have? Since both sides are endless, this is why there is no definite length or endpoints in a line segment. You know that a ray has an endpoint and an endless point. So what is called the endless part of the line? If there is only one inlet parts of a line, that is called a ray. Remember that is called a ray. What does a ray have? Only one endpoint. Next, what does a ray have? No definite length. Now look at the diagram in the screen. You are asked what is called the above diagram or figure. You know that both the sides of this diagram is endless, so it is called a straight line or a line. But here there is another diagram. You are asked what is called the above figure or diagram. Since both the sides are endless, then this diagram is called a line segment. But there is another diagram. Here there is only one endpoint and another is endless parts. You know that it is a figure of a ray. Since there is only one endpoint and another endless point, This is why it is called a figure of a ray. Again, what does this figure called? You know that it is a figure of line segment. Look at this. It is a figure of a circle. But this figure is curved. This line is curved. This is why it is called curved line. And this straight line is vertical. This is why it is called vertical straight line. Next, and this one is horizontal. Horizontal means parallel to land or earth. That is why this line is called horizontal straight line. And you are very much familiar with this type of figure. You know that it is a figure of an angle. You know that there are two sides and a vertex of an angle. Now this diagram, there are two angles adjacent. These angles are called adjacent angles. And this angle is a figure of a right angle. And this one is the figure of a straight angle. And this one, here there are two angles. And sum of these two angles is 90 degrees. This is why this angle is called complementary angle. I again inform you, this class is for the student of class 4 and subject is mathematics. Now, question number 23. What is called the above figure? You know that sum of these two angles is 90 degrees. So, this figure is called complementary angle. Then the next problem, if we add or we find the sum of these two angles is 180 degree. See, this is why this figure is called supplementary angle. Here one line cross to another line and the opposite angles are equal to each other. This is why this figure is called vertically opposite angle. Next, question number 25. What is called the above figure? You know that one line cross another line and intersect at the point O and the angle opposite are equals. We know that vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. So this figure is vertically opposite angle. Next, 26 number problem. What is called the upper region of different objects? All these topics are related to chapter 13. So don't be worried. You should try to learn. The upper region of different objects is called surface. And you know that how many surfaces are there of a brick? Very much important question for your examination. So you should remember that there are six surfaces of a brick. What is called the exterior surface of football? You know that upper portion of the football is curved. This is why that surface of football is called curved surface. Then the next question, where an angle is produced at the meeting point of the two rays? Very much important. If you look at this diagram, here AC is a ray, AB is a ray, another ray, and these two rays meets at the point A. So we can say in point A, an angle has been produced, and that names is the angle of name is CAB. So when two rays meet at a point, in that point an angle is formed. So, in this question, where an angle is produced at the meeting point of the two rays, you know that that meeting point is called vertex. So, if I ask what is called A in the given diagram, you will say that the point A will be called vertex. Then next question, how many sides are there of an angle? It is very much easy for you. You know that there are two sides of an angle. And 31, how many vertex are there of an angle? You know that there is only one vertex. If you look at this diagram again, you will find that only one vertex. Here the name of the vertex of the given angle is A. So there are two sides and only one vertex in an angle. Then what is called unit of angle measurement? You know that angle measurement is called, the unit of angle measurement is called degree. Here you can say the measurement of a right angle is 90 degree. If you look at this on the screen, here the symbol degree given in this note, it is the symbol of degree. So we can say that what is called unit of angle measurement, it is called degree. Then what is used to measure an angle? You know that in previous class I have explained of drawing different angles by measuring a protractor. So we can say what is used to measure an angle, the answer will be protractor. The spelling is little bit difficult, so be careful about the spelling. It will be protractor. Next question, what are the model of two parallel straight lines? You know about, you observe rail lines. So rail lines will be example of parallel straight lines. Next question, what kind of straight lines never intersect? The answer will be two parallel straight lines will never intersect. If you look at this, the diagram, please look at this. Here there are two straight lines and the gap between these two straight lines is always same and they will never intersect each other. So we can say that two parallel lines will never intersect. Then the next question, what is the measurement of a right angle? The measurement of a right angle is 90 degree. The next question, what is the measurement of a straight angle? You know the measurement of a straight angle is 180 degree. Listen to me, all these short questions will be given or may be given in case of MCQ type questions. So if you learn all these short questions, it will be helpful for you to answer MCQ type question. Inshallah, today I will show that after a few minutes. Before that, we will learn the rest of the short questions. Then the next short question, what is the sum of two complementary angles? You know that sum of two complementary angles is 90 degree, which I have explained in this diagram. Here the sum of these two angles is 90 degree and these are called complementary angles. But when you are given only one angle like this, that will be called a right angle. But when you observe two angles in this type of figure, then those angles will be called complementary angles, not right angle. When only one angle or a single angle like this, then you will say that will be called right angle. But when there are two angles in an angle, then you will be called the figure a complementary angle. Here you are asked, what is the sum of two complementary angles? You know that sum of two complementary angles is 90 degree. Next question, what is the sum of two supplementary angles? Here, if you look at this diagram, it is the diagram of supplementary angle. The sum of the angle AOP and the sum of the angle AOP and BOP will be 180 degree. Since the sum of these two angles are 180 degree, so these angles are called supplementary angles. So we can say that sum of two supplementary angles is 180 degree. Be careful about the answer. Then what are vertically opposite angles? You know that, which I have explained say a few minutes ago, that when two lines cross each other, then opposite angles will be equal and these angles are called vertically opposite angle. Angle BOC will be equal angle AOD and angle AOC will be equal angle BOD. And these are called vertically opposite angle. So mutually equal vertically opposite angle. then you are asked, what do you mean by parallel lines? Remember that sometimes definitions are given in your short question. You may be asked, what do you mean by parallel lines? Since the given mark is 1, you should not think about that. You should write the proper definition. Also, you should show the diagram in the examination's answer script. When you are asked, what do you mean by parallel lines? At first, you will show the diagram. Then you will write the definition. Lines are parallel if they are always the same distance apart and will never meet. It has been taken from your textbook. In the above figure, A, B, and C, D are parallel lines. Before writing the definition, you will show the figure at first. After showing the figure in your answer script, then you will write the definition. So remember that before writing the definition, you should show this diagram at first. Then the next question, what do you mean by adjacent angles? At first, you will show the diagram, then you will write the definition. Here I have shown the diagram. Here it is a figure of adjacent angle. When two angles have a common side, here look at this, the name of the angles ABC and the angle CBD. Both angles have a common side. It is BC. It is BC. So, when two angles have a common vertex also and a common side, here common side is BC and common vertex is point B, then those two angles will be called adjacent angles. Here these angles and these angles are adjacent angles. Then the next angle, you know that when the measurement of an angle is 90 degree, that angle will be called a right angle. Here the name of the right angle is BAC and the measurement of this angle is 90 degree. But when you are asked, what do you mean by straight angle? Then you will write, you will show this diagram at first. After showing this diagram in your answer script, you will write the definition. Remember that before writing the definition, you will show the diagram at first. The angle which is 180 degree is called a straight angle. In the above figure, angle BAC is a straight angle. Then the next problem, what do you mean by supplementary angle? Here you know that when sum of two angles is 180 degree, then both the angles will be called supplementary angle. Here angle BA, it will be BAC and DAC. Please remove this, it will be C. Then you will write DAC. So BAC and DAC are supplementary angles to one another. Instead of D, you should write C. Then the next problem, what do you mean by complementary angle? Here, when sum of two angles are 90 degree, when sum of two angles is 90 degree, then one of the angles is complementary angle of the other. So we can say, here sum of two angles, angle BAD and DAC is 90 degrees. So we can say that BAD is supplementary angle of the angle DAC, or DAC is the supplementary angle of angle BAD. Then the next question, what do you mean by vertically opposite angle? Vertically opposite angles are the angles opposite each other when two lines cross. Here, though I have written the definition at first and at the middle of this description, I have shown this diagram. So, it is up to your choice. In this case, only in this case, you can show the diagram between these two descriptions. But I suggest you, at first you will show this diagram, then you will write the definition. In the above figure, angle AB, here you can consider this angle AOC equal to angle BOD and angle AOD equal to angle BOC. You know that vertically opposite angle are equal. Next, What do you mean by perpendicular? A line is perpendicular to another if it meets or intersects it at right angle. That means here CD is perpendicular to AB. And in this point D, a right angle is produced. We can say the measurement of angle ADC equal to 90 degree. And also we can say the angle of angle BDC is 90 degree. So we can say a line is perpendicular to another if it meets or intersects it at right angle. In the above figure, CD is perpendicular to AB. Very much important. So after drawing the diagram, you will write the definition. Then the next question, what is the value of an acute angle? You know that acute angle is smaller than 90 degree. And what is the value of an obtuse angle? You know that the value of obtuse angle is more than 90 degree, but the value of a right angle is 90 degree. And you know that the value of straight angle is 180 degree. Value of complementary angle is 90 degree. And value of what is the value? Very much important. Look at this information. What is the value of 1/3 of a right angle? Be careful. It is not asked about a right angle. It is given the value of 1/3. That means you should multiply 90 degree by 1/3. When you multiply 90 degree by 1/3, you will get 30 degree. That means 90 should be divided by 3. If 90 is divided by 3, the value will be 30 degree. And another question, what is the value of 2/3 of right angle? All these questions are very much important. So I request you, try to learn yourself very carefully at your home. Here it is given 2/3 of a right angle. 2/3 of a right angle means you should multiply the value of right angle by 2/3. When you multiply 90 degree by 2/3, that means at first 90 degree will be divided by 3 and that value will be multiplied by 2. When you divide 90 degree by 3, it will be 30 degree and you should multiply that 30 degree by 2, you will get 60 degree. Then what is the value of half of a right angle? That means you should divide the value of right angle by 2. When you divide 90 degree by 2, you will get 45 degree. Here you are asked, what do you mean by 1 degree? 1 degree is written like this way. Then what is the value of 1/3, which I have explained in previous question? All these have been explained in previous question. So your short question is up to this. Now we will try to learn some MCQ type question, and all the MCQ type questions have been given on the basis of this short question. So don't be worried. Now I will show you some MCQ type question. Yeah, look at the screen. If you look at this, what is called the dot made by the forefront of a pencil on the paper? You have already learned this question in short question part. So I think it will be easier for you to make the correct answer. Here there are four options. You know that the answer will be point. And the next question, what do we get by putting a scale on the paper and joining two points? The answer will be a straight line. You'll be happy to know that all these short MCQ type question have been made on the basis of the previous short question. So if you learn the short questions, then you will be able to give the correct answer of this MCQ type questions. Here the next question. What do we get by putting a scale on the paper and joining two points named A and B? Answer will be a line segment. Look at the next question. What does a line segment have? Answer will be a definite length. I have tried to make similarity between short question and MCQ type question. It will be easier for you to learn the topic. So don't be worried, don't be anxious about the number of the question. You should easily learn this topic. What does a line segment have? You know that a line segment have two endpoints. And what does we get if the line segment is extended in both direction in less? The answer will be a model of a straight line. Then what does a line have? Here the first answer, no definite length, no endpoints. You know that both are correct. So the answer will be both A and B. Here what is called the inlet parts of the line? You know that inlet part of the line is called ray. What does a ray have? Only one endpoint. Only one endpoint. And what does a ray have? Another question, no definite length. But in the question, if it is given option A, what does a ray have? Option A, only one endpoint. Option B, no definite length. Option C, both A and B. In case of that type of question, answer will be both A and B. Here, what is called the above figure? You have already learned this part in short question type question. So the answer will be, it is the figure of a line. And what is called the above figure? Answer will be a line segment. And this is the figure of a ray. Then this is the figure is of a line segment again. And this is the figure of a circle. It is the review of your short question by making MCQ type question. So you should not be worried. And it is the figure of curved line. And this one is the vertically straight line. We have already learned this in short question. So what is called the above figure? You know that this is horizontal straight line. Then this is the figure of an angle. Then this is the figure of adjacent angles. We have a few minutes for the class. So be attentive. Inshallah, tomorrow we will try to learn chapter 7. Inshallah, tomorrow we will try to learn chapter 7. What is called the above figure? You know that this figure is called right angle. And this one is called straight angle. And this one is complementary angle. And this is the figure of supplementary angle. And this is the vertically opposite angle. And you are asked what is called the upper region of different objects. You know that upper region of different object is called surface. And how many surface are there of a brick, or how many surface are there of a book? You know that the answer will be 6. There are 6 surface of a brick. Now, what is called the exterior surface of football? The answer will be curved surface, where an angle is produced at the meeting point of the two rays. How many sides are there of an angle? You know that there are 2 sides of an angle. How many vertex are there of an angle? Answer will be 1. Now the next question, what is called unit of angle measurement? You know that angle measurement is degree. What is used to measure an angle? It is called a protractor. Your time is over, but I will take a few minutes only. What are the model of 2 parallel straight lines? Rail lines. Answer will be rail lines. What kind of straight lines never intersect? Answer will be 2 parallel straight lines. And this part are very much important. What is the measurement of a right angle? You know that the measurement of a right angle is 90 degree. And what is the measurement of a straight angle? Answer will be 180 degree. What is the sum of complementary angles? You know that answer will be 90 degree. And problem number 19, what is the sum of 2 supplementary angles? Answer will be 180 degree. And last problem number 40, what are vertically opposite angles? You know that vertically opposite angles are mutually equal. So your next SW for the next class will be all the short questions and MCQ type questions. Up to MCQ type question is up to 40 and short question is up to 60. So there are 60 short questions and 40 MCQ type questions have been given for your next SW. Inshallah, tomorrow we will take part in the class at 1 p.m. So I request you, you will practice yourself, learn at your home. You will try to learn all the short questions and MCQ type questions. So your next SW is MCQ type questions 1 up to 40 and short question is 1 up to 60. Our today's class is up to this. So thank you everybody. Thank you all. Inshallah, tomorrow we will meet at 1 p.m. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.